I just spent half of 2024 learning how to make VFX, and I'll be showing the best plugins and tips to help you on your VFX journey. First important thing is to change your editor quality. Start by opening up a new experience, then add a part and a particle emitter. We have an example effect to show how important changing the quality is. Click on File, then Studio Settings, then click on Rendering and set editor quality level to 21, and you'll instantly see a difference. Changing the editor quality is like changing your graphic settings to 10 in a Roblox game. It makes a massive difference. Now on to plugins. In the description below, I have links for all plugins I'll be showcasing. The plugins you should download are VFX Editor, Particle Scaler, Ros Particle Editor, and Celestial Body Dragger, which are all free. The last two plugins that are paid is VFX Suite and Zonito Visuals. I'll be starting with VFX Editor. Click on the Plugins tab and enable VFX Editor. One of the best features of this plugin is being able to update textures in real time, so you need a texture pack to download first. Head to the toolbox and search up Bringus Particle Pack and click on the first option. Now click on the icon of VFX Editor to open it, then select the particle you made at the start of the video. With the particle selected, click the plus sign, which adds the particle into the plugin. Scroll down to texture and click on none. This will open another window where you store your textures. I already have textures here, but yours will look empty. Now select the Bringus particle pack in the workspace, then click on the small download button and click import instances. A new window will show up where you can finally click import items. Now you can select your particle and freely change the texture in real time. I mainly use VFX Editor for updating textures onto my particles, and I don't really use it to change properties, as I change them in the default editor, but it comes down to preference to how you edit your particles. Moving on to Particle Scaler. Enable Particle Scaler in the Plugins tab. Now select your particle and click on the icon. You are now able to freely scale your particle to however you like, but this works really well when you need to scale multiple particles at once. This plugin may also be preference, but it helps to increment effects through a slider instead of going up one by one in the default properties. Moving on to Ros Particle Editor. Enable Ros Particle Editor and select your particle. The only thing I use Ros Particle Editor for is to see the trajectory of particles. It's super useful to see the shape of your particles and where they will be emitted. This editor has other features, being able to edit graphs of size, squash, and transparency, but it again comes down to preference whether you use this editor or the default editor to edit graphs. Moving on to Celestial Body Dragger. Enable Celestial Body Dragger. With this, you can just drag the moon and sun for effects with lighting, bloom, or glow. Just click on the sun or moon icon, then click anywhere in your game view to move them. Super simple plugin, but very useful. Now moving on to two super important plugins, starting with VFX Suite. Now enable VFX Suite. A bunch of UI will pop up, and I'll disable everything by clicking the icons on the bottom right. Disable your particle with the square icon, then on the top left, there are three options for emitting particles. The emit button will emit the amount of particles you input. You can also delay particles from when you click emit in seconds. Duration is how long the particles last after clicking emit. For the next icon, re-enable your particle, and I'm going to add two attachments and a trail into my part. Then if you enable trail preview, the part will move in an orbit in a circle path to preview the trail. Disable trail preview, and the next icon is increments. I don't really use this, but you can use it to very slightly increment your effects if you need super specific properties. Next is the size modifier, which I use all the time. You can multiply your particle's size by however you want. 1 is times 1 multiplier, 1.5 is times 1.5, and 0.5 is halving your particle size. The next icon is where you can copy and paste properties from particle to particle. So here I'm going to dupe this particle and change the color. I'm going to copy the color and select the other particle and paste it. This works for literally any property and saves a bunch of time. For the clock icon, you can change how fast or slow your effect appears. 1 is real time, 0.5 is halftime, 2 is times 2 speed, and so on. Moving on to graphs, this plugin comes with some graph presets already, and I highly recommend using them, as this is one of the few ways I know to make curved graphs. Note, you can only graph size, squash, and transparency. Points are how smooth the graph will curve. Min should always be 0 or 1. Max is how big you want the effect to be, and I'm not sure what envelope does, but it just makes the graph smoother usually. It's like a buffer, making everything less jagged. Graphs can really make or break an effect, but they are tough to explain, so they may need a whole nother video. Lastly is the settings of VFX Suite. You really only have to change your UI scale depending on how big your screen is. I have mine at 125% since I have a small screen. That should be the most basic functions of VFX Suite. This is my main plugin to edit every effect I make. And if you want more info on it, check out Brad's video of it in the description. Moving on to the last plugin, Zonito Visuals. Enable Zonito Visuals, open it through the little arrow on the bottom and click on the blue icon. This will open a window with thousands of textures and hundreds of very high quality flipbooks. Just select your particle and click on the texture or flipbook you want, and then click replace. I really recommend buying this plugin. Here are some examples of some flipbooks. I mainly use this plugin for flipbooks and textures, and I highly recommend it. Well, that's everything. If you have more questions, please ask in the comments. This is my first tutorial I've made for VFX, so please leave feedback, good or bad. And if you can, subscribe, and thank you for watching.